overwhelmed with kindness.
Woo!
You guys, it just surprised me with this cake. I can't believe it. Also, someone's taking this home, not me. Hafsa, you're gonna get in the video regardless.
Ooh, it's 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm still on campus. It's Tuesday. Yesterday was my birthday, or 2 days ago. So I guess technically since it's 2 a.m. Today's October 31st. My birthday was on Monday, October 29th. Don't worry, I'm about to go home. But yeah, guys, this is just giving you a little taste. Just a little taste of what we do here. It's the first snow of the year, guys. Well, technically it snowed a little bit last month, but this is the first official snow, and it's November 8th, if that gives you any indication of what this winter might be like. It's November. It's November.
When it's snowing outside and you don't have a fireplace, but you still have to find a way to keep it homey. But you gotta study about atrioventricular valves and the heart conduction and blood flow and pressures and volumes and
said I'm guys. I haven't been vlogging as much, not really. It's Sunday. We had our cardioplumb exam a week from tomorrow, so it was this past Monday. And our next exam is our cardioplumb final. And then it's Thanksgiving, inshallah. I just came from brunch, and now I'm trying to get a full day, well, I guess half a day of studying, because it's 2 p.m. But I need to get caught up with everything that we learned last week before the new material starts pouring in tomorrow.
So I'm in Nicole's apartment. Never been here before, and it's a cute studio. She's gonna give us a tour.
Okay. This is the study. AKA where the magic of knowledge happens.
Mm-hmm.
This is the library, where all the books are smushed all up in there. This is the dining room, AKA corner, where I never hardly eat.
Where do you usually eat your bed?
I don't even, standing up, drinking from a thing.
I don't even
this is the bathroom.
Okay. Where the other magic
happens. Where the other magic happens. This is the laundry room, the washer and the dryer.
Okay.
This is the storage closet where I have, like, I don't know, things that I don't use. This is the other storage closet if you need TP.
It smells so good in here.
Or
it smells like brownies.
Paper towels. This is the pantry, the juicer that I don't have time to do that anymore. This is the fridge, the other pantry. This is literally my counter space. This is actually my counter. This is the kitchen. This is the living room. This becomes a bed also. So this is also
the
guest room. My dad made this.
Your dad made this?
Yeah.
This is like something you've had for a long time.
Yeah.
This is amazing.
This is the bedroom. This is the garden. And that's the wardrobe.
Oh, I didn't even notice the closet.
Yeah. Smashed up in there. This is my storage and all of that.
You're so organized.
I'm trying to be. I mean, you have to be when you live in like 200
You have Tennessee up there.
Hey. Yep. Shout out, Tennessee.
It's perfect. Laura DIY?
No. She's a doctor, dermatologist, and her husband is they're both residents. No. She's half black, half Puerto Rican.
Oh, wait, I've seen that. And they have a kid?
Three.
Yeah.
They have kids. Three girls. You need to get on that level so that you can be rich. And adopt all of us.
I don't want to be a dermatologist.
No, do her blogging and all that stuff.
You have to blog that way.
Second snowfall of the winter, I guess. I mean, technically it's still fall. I went to class and we have another class, but I'm like, I need to be home. I don't want to be out here. I'll come back later when it stops snowing.
Don't make them.
Tennessee. I've been keeping the secret for months, and I told her I wasn't gonna come till winter break, yet here I am. Didn't really vlog that much because just been enjoying my time with my family. There's a Heech. Heech, are you struggling?
Yeah. Don't
we
get
got,
this.
We got Hi. Anna. We got Huda.
We're all kind of struggling right now.
I'm not struggling.
What are you doing? I'm trying to make sure that
I'm like, I'm a queen. I'm fine.
I don't know.
Anyway. These are the struggles that hijabis have behind the scenes. Yeah, that bed is really sinky. Okay, we gotta get our stuff so we can go. Huda, are you bringing your purse?
Oh, yeah.
Hey! What's up?
First door, first door. Okay. Do it for the vlog. Do it for the vlog.
Look at the roofs of the red. Right here. You can kind of see it blowing around. Like a lot.
Guys, it is 10:39. We've been here since 6 a.m.
Oh, yeah, man. I mean, there are times where, like, I'll make their lunch.
You want to know what our schedule is like this week? We had a test on Monday. Right? That was Monday, right?
Mm-hmm.
We had a test on Monday, and then we had another test on Tuesday. And today's Wednesday. Tomorrow's Thursday. We have a test on Friday. And then we have another test on Monday. Did you hear what I just said? Did you hear what I said?
Sparkling water?
No.
I'm dying. Please show us the sandwich your son made.
Say everything. Less is hot. Sandwich is made by a 5-year-old with love for mommy's lunch.
Oh, is there any mayonnaise in there?
What do you say?
Is there any mayonnaise?
No, it's just bread and ham.
Oh, man.
It's going to be delicious. Like those extras.
Is that your lunch?
No, I ate stuff already.
But was that your lunch?
What, this?
Or that was just...
Yeah, what did you eat for lunch?
Yeah.
I don't think I saw you eat lunch.
Oh, okay.
Was that your lunch?
That was just vegetables.
I ate, like,
I'm losing my garden!
I ate my fruits, and then I ate my veggies.
I've been here
since. These are like the extra snacks. The whole long.
I've been here since 5:45 in the morning.
Throw it.
Oh, here we go.
Tell me if this is good. Oh, wait. I want to do
this. No.
No, not all of that.
Yeah, do it.
Girl, just throw it, dude. For sure, we're going to lose the room. For sure.
Thank you. Let me throw it.
Guys, we've been here way too long.
No pitches. No
bottom of the ninth.
No pitches.
Bases are full.
Now you're doing baseball pitching.
Oh my God.
T1, 2, 3, T4, 5, 6, T7, 8, 9, T10, T11, T12. But what is it?
I'm so embarrassed. You really are. And I don't know what possesses you to do the things that you do. You just do them.
I'll be fine.
What are you guys about to do?
Finish this lecture.
Actually, like that.
Salam, everybody. What's up? So, I haven't uploaded in a long time.
This is really weird that I'm standing in front of the camera and talking because I usually do not do this. But thought I would give you guys just a little bit of a recap of what's been going on. Obviously, studying is a thing. Exams are a thing. So, medical school. Guys, medical school is really hard. And obviously, like, I knew that was a thing. For sure, like, I knew that was a thing. And they were talking to us about it during orientation and about burnout and about mental health and things like that. But God, I never realized what it was like legit. When it comes to burnout, I'm sure you guys have heard that term. But I always imagined that burnout was, like, sudden. Like, you felt it after one thing happened, let's say, for example, and then that's, like, you're burnt out. But I started realizing right before our last course, right before the final, that burnout is, like, a culmination of so many things. It's, like, not getting enough sleep every day, not exercising enough when you used to, not eating right, using all your time studying, not doing things that you love, becoming just absorbed into your studies and your books, and that's all you do. And it's that gradual doing it, and that leads to burnout. And I started feeling that about a couple weeks ago, and I had been going hard for like 3.5 months. And then right around that 3.5 month point, like, I just started feeling it. Like, I was tired, I was just kind of feeling unmotivated, didn't want to study, didn't really want to get out of bed. Like, I literally would just go home after lecture and just be like, man, I'm gonna take a nap. But alhamdulillah, went to Thanksgiving break and I feel revitalized and rejuvenated. We actually had a blizzard here, crazy. I managed to get back to Kansas City right before the blizzard hit. Like, I got into my apartment and it started snowing an hour later. And the flight that I had out of Chicago was the last flight that day. Like, everything after that was canceled. I was so terrified I was gonna be stuck in Chicago. But alhamdulillah, I wasn't. So right now I have like 10 more minutes and I have to go back to campus because I have a lecture. But this was just like my lunch break to decompress. I've been in lecture since 8 a.m. and it's 12:30. So we had a lecture from 8 to 12. Literally, we had a lecture from 8 to 9. And then we had another lecture from 9 to 12. And it was just like, I felt like my brain was melting. So I just told myself, you know what? I usually don't do this, but I'm gonna come home. I'm gonna eat some food I make. I'm gonna watch some YouTube or whatever, watch a vlog. I enjoy vlogs. And then I looked over at my camera sitting here in the tripod and I was like, maybe I'll do a little update. Maybe I'll just tell people what's going on. So yeah, that's what's going on. I'll probably upload this after my exam on Monday, inshallah. But whoever has subscribed newly, thank you. I've actually gotten a sudden burst of subscribers, so that's great. I don't really take this YouTube too seriously. This is kind of just like for me and just in case anyone else wants to know what it's like to be a medical student who's black or female or hijabi or, you know, Muslim, whatever, what involves that. So if you guys have any questions, you can ask me, interact with me. You can follow me on Instagram. I don't really go on Twitter that much. You can ask me questions on Instagram. You can ask me questions in the comments. I'm really not expecting that much interaction. I'm here and I'm making these videos because I want to share my experiences as a medical student, specifically a black female Muslim hijabi medical student. And I feel like we're so rare. But at the same time, like, I'm so down for sharing like MCAT scores, GPA, how I study, how long it took me to get into medical school, like my journey to get here from undergrad. Some of you guys might know it, some of you guys don't. But at the same time, like, time is definitely a constraint, so if I do those videos, it might be like during a break. I personally, as an African-American, you know, black student, I didn't know anything. I was doing so many things like on my own. Neither of my parents went to college, so it was kind of just like me troubleshooting and trying to figure everything out. So if I can be of any assistance to anyone who wants to end up where I am, I would love to help. So if you guys let me know what kind of videos you want to see or what kind of questions you have or anything I can answer, I'm so down. And that's all. Thank you guys for watching this. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace and assalamu alaikum.